Hey, can I get one ticket, please?
Yeah, you made it just in time for the trailers.
Oh, sweet. Thank you.
It'll be in Theater 5 down in West Hall.
Awesome. Thanks. Theater 5.
There she is, the uncatchable blue T-Rex.
How are we gonna catch her? We have to do something different, something no one's tried before, something creative.
You know what we could do is that we can bait her out into an open field and she won't be able to see us because we can hide behind the bushes. And then, Joey, if you grab your shrink gun out of the car, we can shrink her and then we'll have about 30 minutes to go get the helicopter, fly it back, tie her up, and then fly that sucker out of here. Is everyone active listening?
Yeah, we were listening. But like, good. How are we gonna get her safely into the helicopter without hurting her?
I saw this video once that if we wrap her around, like wrap the chains, the 10-pound chains out of the back of the helicopter around each of her legs and one around the torso, that way it'll even out her like weight and it won't hurt her in any way, and so she'll be safe on the trip out. Does everyone understand?
Yeah, I understand.
I think we're ready.
Wait, guys, where'd she go? Hi guys, so like you just saw in the last video, it was an example of active listening, and we have an article here for you, and it's titled The Power of Active Listening, and it's by R. Smith, and it was published in February 2011. It states, it's also important that you avoid the temptation to interrupt. More often than not, we interrupt with our own thoughts and ideas, in other words, our own agenda. And one of the most important steps in active listening is providing and receiving feedback. And now, we're going to go back to the video.
Well, well, here we are.
While you were here, you were not conducting any verbal communication. While you were here, you will not participate in any fun activities.
Can I read my book?
No talking! You will not move, draw, do homework, or fall asleep until detention is over. It is now 7:06. You have 8 hours and 54 minutes to think about what you've done. Questions?
Yeah, does the 80s know you read against losers?
A nerd. The popular. A jock. A rebel. Before this day is over, they're going to break the rules.
I've got a hunger twisting my stomach into knots that my tongue is tied off. My brain's repeating, if you've got an impulse, let it out. But they never make me pass that
out. Why don't you spend a little more time trying to do something with yourself and a little less time trying to impress others? You might be better off.
See us how you want to see us, in the simplest terms, the most convenient. Sincerely, The Breakfast Club.
stomach into knots. In the last trailer we had seen an example of nonverbal communications in an article I had found by David Matsumoto titled Nonverbal Communication Speaks Volumes. It stated a big facial expressions that is very clear about what the person's mental state is. To read macro expressions and nonverbal behaviors is very valuable to anyone. To understand other people's true feelings, thoughts, motivations, personalities, and or intentions.
Wait, guys, what's the plan?
There's a poltergeist terrorizing a family and we have to go into the home, capture it, and destroy it.
Okay, but what's our group role gonna be?
I think I have a plan. Taylor, you distract the ghost. Get his attention and get him to chase you into a corner.
I don't understand.
You have to get his attention and then have him chase you into a corner.
Okay, I got it.
All right, then after that, Marissa, Charity, and I will go around and capture him with our proton guns and then we'll be good to go.
Yeah.
All right, gang, let's go get this ghost.
Let's go save this poor family. Hey, guys, wait.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters! There's something weird. All right, guys, we'll split up. You gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
I just have to breathe! Oh my god!
I ain't afraid of no ghosts. I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
Alright guys, in the last video we saw a reference to small groups, and in an article titled Small Groups by Richard Moreland, he states that most people belong to an array of informal and formal groups that influence them in both obvious and subtle ways. These groups include families, friendship cliques, work crews, sports teams, and so on. Many daily activities are carried out in such groups, which are not only important to their own right, but also connect people to larger social institutions. In many cases, group influence is easy to recognize and involves coordinated responses by people with common goals. Guys, Dr. Evil Group Think has struck again in another small groups class.
Combat Dr. Groupthink.
Well, groupthink only occurs when all members agree without conflict due to the lack of creativity and the real personal input.
So, can we keep a positive group climate in the groups without leading to groupthink?
I think we can stop them by using more questions. We have to get the members to question each other's ideas to lead to more input.
Perfect. Now all we have to do is make sure that we all understand the charge. How will we do that? We will just need to make sure we all know our assigned tasks to take down Dr. Groupthink. We will need to come up with more questions.
Perfect. Everybody, we need to start brainstorming and then we get suit up.
All right, let's take down this menace.
Yeah, let's go.
Wait, did you drop the Bunsen burner?
Oh, the trailer sucked. I'm going home.